Hello and welcome to another step-by-step how to tie tutorial video. This is Lee's Ferry Shrimp. This is part of the A to Z tying series. This is the letter L out of my Norwegian book that I'm working out of. This is tied on a Mustad 9671. It's a 2x long shank hook with a down eye. I am using a white tying thread. The body is basic dubbing. For this, I am using Antron sand. And everything else on there consists of white deer belly hair. Doesn't get any more belly than that. And that's basically it. Two ingredient recipe. So let's go ahead and remove our sample. We can secure our hook in the vise. And to start this off, I'm going to start off with an excessively long tag end because we're going to use that for our ribbing. And like all good flies, this will begin but with a single wrap of thread. We'll start that right behind the head. And we're just going to continue our thread along the shank of the hook all the way to the bend. Excellent. Let's go ahead and wax our thread. And we're going to put this dubbing on in stages. As we put the dubbing on, we're going to use the less is more mentality. And we're not going to build too thick of dubbing noodles. We want this to be nice and dense. And for this first little bit, I'm just going to do the rear half of the hook. And I'm going to work my way towards the bend. Ideally, what I'm looking for here is a taper with the large end being towards the rear of the hook, tapering down towards the eye, which is the rear end of the shrimp. So we'll just build this on in stages. All right, after that first pass, I'm going to continue forward just a little bit more. And just continue my process of wax and dub. Got tight quarters here with the camera in the way, but we'll get through this. We're just going to keep dubbing back and forth, slowly working our way forward each time. Take this one just a little bit more further. And by waxing the thread, it really helps to hold the dubbing A on the thread. And once the fly is completed, I believe it increases the longevity of the dubbing. If you're having issues, especially with a soft dubbing like a rabbit or a hare's ear, something really slippery. Definitely want to use that wax to give that a bite. Continuing on with our sand antron here. I like the way this is starting to shape up. Just continuing to layer it on. I have a little bit of residual wax on my fingers. So sometimes if you have waxy fingers, you can skip an application from time to time. Here we go. I think I'm satisfied with that. All right, we'll take our deer belly hair. This is coming right off of the belly. And we're going to take a small section. Trim it off the hide. And always, 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 what we're going to do is we're going to clean out all the junk out. Get rid of all that garbage. There will always be plenty to clean. There's no such thing as overcleaning your hair. It gets all over the place, but we get by. All right, I'm going to take my hair. I'm going to line up the tips. Run it through my stacker here. Tips down. Got one. One going AWOL there. We'll go ahead and put that in, tips down. We'll give that a shake a couple of times. Excellent. Take our lined up tips. We're going to tie those in forward. Give your thread a couple of counterclockwise rotations. And secure that on the front. Lift it up, and we're going to take some tight wraps underneath. And at this time, we're done with our tying thread on this end. So we'll come in and carefully do our 1, 2, 3 whip finish. 1, 2, 3. Secure that down, and we'll trim off our tying thread. That in itself could actually be its own fly. We're going to do is we're going to fold down the hair. And for simplicity's sakes, I'm just going to do forward wraps with my thread, because at the end I will be doing a whip finish. Secure the hair down at the bend. And check our sides, make sure our material is all stayed up on the top. Think that'll work. Now we're just going to take a couple of forward open spiral turns. And any loose ones you can just trim off afterwards. Come underneath once again, a couple of tight wraps. And having a long length of tying thread to hold on to really helps. It's a little bit of a waste, but it's worth not having the hassle and the discomfort of trying to do this with a short piece of thread. All right, now we'll come in with our razor scissors. We'll trim off our strays. All right, now this whole back end, we're going to give that a nice even trim. Excellent, starting to look a little shrimpy. And to secure everything down, we're going to add a little bit of secret sauce, some good old Sally Hansen's. And I'm just going to apply this directly on top of the fly, right on the body. Let that soak into those deer hair fibers. That'll give us a little life and longevity on this fly. So, there you have it, folks. L is for Lee's Ferry Shrimp. It says tied on a size 10. Thank you for watching. Happy tying, and with this one, tight lines.